theater garage, not far from our own, the human-eating plant was unsuccessful in its attempt to take over the Earth. Yet this terrifying enemy surfaced, as such enemies often do, in the theater district of New York City.
Have a ball.
Alfred 2 continues to consume greedy Broadway characters.
Not everyone is that greedy.
No, sure looks that way on Broadway, honey.
You do know that musicals have an I Want song. It's not greed. It's about wishes, dreams.
Listen, Sondheim. If they sound greedy, they taste greedy.
Seafood.
No. She's just a child. Get away from here, Annie.
Just a child? You eat children. Ever heard of veal or lamb or eggs?
Just stop. Annie's an orphan, singing about fighting her parents.
Yeah? Well, I'm a plant. You think I know who my parents were? Sorry, you can't have it all.
I'm asking, I heard him say, gotta find me a future, move out of my way.
Thank you. city is completely unique. The highs and lows of Prussian and German history took place here. War, defeat, division, reunification. Berlin. Du bist die eine, der ich treu bin. So verrückt, so schön, doch wunderschön. Beim Untergang warst du die Zeugin. Jetzt schau dich an, wirst nie vergehen. Und deine Falten viel zu tief, dein Lachen so rau. Und doch bin ich dir verfallen. Als ich nach dir rief, wusste ich genau, du bist die Beste doch.
No one else is in the room where it happens. No one else is in the room. Evans. Thomas Clay.
Alexander was on Washington's doorstep one day in distress and dismay.
Thomas Clay.
Alexander said,
I had nowhere else to turn.
And basically begged me to join the fray.
Thomas Clay.
I approached Madison and said, I know you hate him. Let's hear what he has to say.
Thomas Clay.
Super Califragilistic.
crouching would suffice. Now if they heard this word, they might have used it once or twice. I'm sure Egyptian pharaohs would have cast it in a jiff. Then every single pyramid began its life of birth. Oh, supercalifragilisticexpialidocious. Say it, and while animals would not seem so ferocious, Adam further flourishes in sorocococious.
I see.
accent and goop.
I'm not sure who this girl is.
Marston Park, recent transfer.
Second, the
Fox News team, as if you can even call it news, is constantly demonizing anyone who promotes multiculturalism, tolerance, or even science. Third, many here at Putnam County are influenced by FOX, so it would be safe to assume that...
Please just spell the word.
Atheist. Seriously? What kind of oversimplified definition do you have?
A person who does not believe in the existence of a god or an afterlife.
That makes it sound like atheists believe in nothing. I would like to hear you use it in a sentence.
Because he was a...
atheist.
Billy was not bothered by the other kids chanting, "Go to hell, Billy, go to hell."
Do you notice how there's always a male in your sentences? Atheist. A-T-H-E-I-S-T. Atheist.
Miss Poppins?
Many girls hoping to be in the middle school musical went home crying when they found out Mary Poppins was auditioning.
Your word is...
supercalifragilisticexpialidocious.
May I have the definition?
Extremely happy, euphoric, helping you believe you can achieve anything!
May I have that in a sentence?
Bipolar Mary said she often went from feeling
supercalifragilisticexpialidocious
to meh. And would you like that forwards or backwards?
I was afraid of that.
supercalifragilisticexpialidocious. C-I-O-U-Q?
Yes, so close. The last letter was an S.
Oh, man. You were so close. Here, sis, have a juice.
Oh, aren't you precious?
Hey, don't worry about it. It's okay. Hey, I have some sugar for you.
And do you have a spoon?
Actually, I do. Here you go.
Wipe it off.
Here you go. A spoonful of sugar.
Well, isn't that sweet of you?
Could you use it in a sentence, please?
Well,
While the team was playing shirts versus skins in basketball scrimmage, coach shouted, "Billy, stop it with the
omphaloskepsis
already and watch the bleeping ball."
"Can you spell it, please?"
You guys are seeing this, right?
Oh my god. I think some of my Gatorade just came out of my nose. Sorry.
"Mr. Cody Bear, please spell
omphaloskepsis."
"Well, I don't know how to spell.
But I've had a good time here at the 25th annual Putnam County Spell. O-M-P-H-A-L-O-S-K-E-P-S-I-S.
Omphaloskepsis.
Oh, that's correct.
Really?
Thank you.
you never really had enough faith in me that you gave up the factory. Well, this time I'm gonna take that chance. Leap into the past expense. This time I'm gonna see my destiny.
Thank you. There's a road. Change our profit, gentlemen. Right now, we charge the newsies 50 cents for 100 papers.
But if we put the prices up to 60 cents for 100,
they would need to sell more newspapers to make the same amount of money. It's genius.
It's gonna be awful tough on those boys, Mr. Pulitzer.
Tough? Nonsense. I'm giving them a real-life lesson in economics.
Yes.
I couldn't give them a better education if they were my own.
So, lads, the prices have gone up to 60 cents for 100.
Mr. Bunton, this is the only way we make a buck. You can't take it away by just raising the price. Anyone planning on buying at these prices?
No!
We can't afford to strike. Nobody can, but we have to.
right, blowing pipes are from Upper Mount Bat.
Sort of a, kind of a, hat-wearing
cat!
I can see that you've got quite a mind for your age. Why, one think, and you drag me right out onto the stage. Now I'm here. And there's no telling what may ensue. With a cat such as me, and a thinker like you. Oh, the things you can think. Oh, the things you can think. If you're willing to try. Think invisible ink, or a gink with a snake, or a stare to the sky. When you open your mind, oh, the things you can find, lining up to get loose. All the things you can think.
His head smashed in and his heart ripped out and his liver removed and his bowels
Nostrils ripped and his bottom burnt off and his penis
that
slit.
That's enough music for now, lads.
I'm the king of the Britons.
Raved so long and ran away. He bravely ran away, away.
With danger ring his ugly head, he simply soiled himself instead.
Arthur, king of the Britons. Oh, don't grovel. One thing I can't stand is people groveling.
Sorry, Lord.
And don't apologize. Every time I try to talk to someone, it's sorry this and forgive me that, and we're not worthy. What are all of you doing, dancing and singing around in Camelot?
Well, this is sort of a musical review, Lord. They're singing and dancing.
Well, that seems a bit silly. Whose idea was that? never mind. Arthur, King of the Britons, I have a challenge for your knights to become heroes.
These knights, Lord?
Of course these knights. Some people just need a challenge. Now this shall be your quest. The quest for the Holy Grail.
God be praised. We have a quest.
To find the Grail.
The Quail?
Oh no, the Grail. The vessel used at the Last Supper.
Wait, there was a boat at the Last Supper? Awesome.
No. The Grail is a cup.
Wait, let me get this straight. God, the Almighty, the All-Knowing, has misplaced a cup?
Apparently. Well, that doesn't seem very realistic. God, All-Knowing, he...
Or she
is supposed to have lost the Grail.
Oh, this seems so very Grail-less. He
or she
must have an other cup.
But, I know we are asking for money at the door, so can't we just get a new cup? That's good.
Look, it's not about a missing cup. It's a metaphor. We must all look within us. That's where we'll find the Grail.
Wait. It's inside us? Like, somebody ate it?
Nobody ate it! It's a symbol! Oh, look! Just go and find it! See what you learn about yourselves.
Looking for a cup? That was not part of my goal.
What ever happened to my heart?
My girl? You said you did not want any solos.
Oh, you're right, God. I forgot. Sorry.
Whatever happened to my past?
Dan, you said you wanted to stay in the band.
Whatever happened to my heart?
See, that's more believable.
It was exciting at the start.
Now we're halfway through Act Two, and I've had nothing yet to do.
I've been off stage for far too long.
Sing from my
bless you. Find your grail.
Between. wonder, love, and joy. And even though you can find most of their names on our program, we would like to thank most of the people who have made Musical Mania 2023 possible.
Please indulge as we take our individual bows.